school. It would also look at the cost to rent portable classrooms versus leasing them with the option to purchase. We need to get more information again from Russ as far as how many classrooms would be needed if we were going to consider this portable classroom option. We also need to know how much space would be needed if we were going to put on an addition, and we'd have to have a, and would we have a problem scheduling gym classes and lunch breaks with only one gym and one cafeteria? There's a lot of unanswered questions at the time. The cost to renovate the middle high school was $2,207,494. We're not sure if this price was to convert to a pre-K through 8 or if the price was just to work on fixing the issues with the school as it is now. A lot of unanswered questions at this point with Russ and the school committee trying to get the schools open in the next few weeks. So we're trying to lead them to do that. But once that's done, we'll be looking to get more information from Russ. Because of this, the committee has decided the October deadline set forth was not acceptable or reasonable for the Article 8 committee to provide a comprehensive plan to the school board, both due to time and complications of COVID and school reopening. Committee members strongly feel the need to research, or the need for research from EEI to help determine a proper proposal or options. Ideally, the committee will review that information once available, and once we're able to get more information from Russ, we'll review that and submit a proposal within 45 to 60 days.
Okay. Thanks. So, in the spirit of reopening and staying focused on that, I do want to have just a board discussion on their update in 2 weeks. So if they've made any progress, you can update us again, or we'll work off that document. See how the board's thinking. We can take a look at what the guidelines were versus the work being done, just sort of have a check and a balance. But I think it'd be more appropriate to have that after I give Russ some time and the staff to stay focused on the goal of opening.
Jesse, can I just say, all our meetings and stuff, excuse me, get recorded, get sent to Russ, and go up on the school website. So the general public can see it.
Yep.
And our Zoom meetings on there too, so you can sit back and watch that if you're tired of watching Netflix.
Yeah, so if you're curious, it's public. It's the citizen's voice, so you guys have, everybody has access to it. But I think it's, appreciate the work, appreciate the update, and we can talk more next, in 2 weeks. That's all I had. Anything else? Anything else? Anybody else? All right. I'm not going to look at Scott. Can I get a motion to approve the manifest as listed, and then got to do another payroll review properly? Any motions? It's an in here. We'll keep the sports thing going.
Ed? I'll make a motion to approve the basic manifest 2021-1, $74,005.06. 2021-2, $233,702.31. Payroll manifest 2021-04, $68,744.41.
We can back on. Do I have a second on that?
Second.
Okay. Any discussion, question? Went into a SAU after hours. I left the door open for me to read through all of these and sign them one night. I was like, I don't think they understand. The average public attending the meeting realizes what happens in between the meetings. So appreciate it. All in favor of approving the AP manifest, the payroll manifest is listed, please say aye.
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 Aye. Public forum. Please.
Good evening. Amy Chewy, I just wanted to comment and voice my support for Call Sports. I have 3 kids who play sports in the district. Actually, we've had a mistake on that throughout this whole thing. And as a parent, there's inherent risk in any time I send my kids out on a field or on a bus to go to an event. So I just wanted to voice that and let you know.
for being here and voicing your opinion. Appreciate it. Others? Mike?
I have a couple of questions I can answer and comment. From last night's meeting, I think Sean, you mentioned 96% of our classrooms here at the middle high school are social business now.
Yeah, right now we're looking about 96% would be able to do so, correct?
Yeah. So what we have public comment.
Yep.
We don't do Q&A. I'm going to break the protocol of last night. If there's a specific question about reopening, like you just asked, that's cool. I don't want to have this veer off. So if you're staying within opening questions, and parents of students, if you have additional questions from last night, please take your turn asking them. That's not how this is structured, but we got to stick to reopening as the core topic.
Well, that's what I'm
okay.
saying.
Okay. With that understanding, if we're okay with it, please play through. Go for it.
Okay. Elementary school, do we have a number on that as far as how much we are right there with?
Do you have?
At this point in time, I would say 100% of our classes are socially distanced.
And then the other comment, however you want to call it, I believe last night, Sean, you mentioned we're not going to hire any substitute teachers, but we hired two full-time normal teachers that are going to kind of cover in case a teacher's out. I guess the big question that I heard today was, what if six teachers come down with this? How's two going to cover the classroom? What's the plan?
So I'll answer that. We hired two substitute paraprofessionals right now to float, one in each building, not teachers, to help fill in four teachers. What happens if six folks go out, Mike? We are going to be in direct contact with the Department of Health and Human Services, and if we had six go out, I imagine they may be telling us to close. But that would be, again, with direct communication with Health and Human Services.
Do any parents in attendance have additional questions that we can help you with? You're welcome to just make a public statement of any opinion. Yes, you're right. But if you have reopening questions, we also want to be flexible to that. The floor is yours, please.
All right. Well, I'm Nicole Galloway. My son is a junior here at the school, a three-sport athlete, so I obviously came in support of all sports. Being an educator myself, I work in a private school in special education, so we have obviously gone through the whole gamut of what reopening looks like. I am OCD and ADHD and all of this combined. I look at the numbers every single day. I'm a numbers person. That's how my brain works. Looking at the numbers across the state, obviously we are coming from an area where our numbers are really, really low. We're very fortunate that we are in a school district that our class sizes and our grades, there's like 32 kids in the entire junior class, that our school size is pretty small as well. I guess one question that I may have is why are we limiting our sports to just the teams in the area when we're also playing other small schools who are also having other towns that have low numbers? I didn't know if that was just a limited exposure, even though that their numbers are also low, or if it was due to a busing issue. But I think, as you know, Sean had mentioned, the social emotional health of our students is really important. I've read a lot of pamphlets and readouts regarding COVID and its impact it's had on kids, and they say as important as education is to the students that we have here, athletics is just as important. And the fact that 80% of our population here plays sports, that speaks volumes. And so if you were to look at minimizing or decreasing what sports may look like for the kids here at school, I think you're going to have a negative impact on us finishing number two in the state, because you're going to have a lot of kids that are going to start becoming depressed and anxious and all of these other things that are going to start coming out and being prevalent. So then you're going to have kids who are going to be failing classes and not doing well in classes because they're not going to have the support of their coaches, the support of their teammates, the support of their friends that are going to help boost them up, that make them want, okay, well, if you're failing the class, you can't play, you can't be on our team, or can't even see changes, you're not going to be able to play. Those type of things is what keeps this community what it is. We're number two in the state for a reason. We have a strong sports team or sports program here for a reason. It'd be sad to see that go away. And knowing the fact that, you know, my son came here today, we saw Mr. Moynihan and, you know, Mrs. Reed coming in and checking in, just a little bit of normalcy to get our kids back on track, I think is going to make a world of difference. I mean, as Amy said, our kids are going to come in contact with things regardless of where they go. You know, we could go to a grocery store and as safe as we are, come in contact with someone who may be potentially infected. But we want to give our kids the opportunity to be able to play sports because I think that it will have a huge negative impact on them if we don't.
Appreciate you being here, sharing your opinion. For sports is very important to a lot of people. This significant update tonight than we did before. We'll hear from you again in 2 weeks. You're welcome at that meeting to, you're certainly gonna ask questions directly to Mr. Holden, Mr. Moynihan, but I think, you know, I meant to start the meeting by saying, we're coming into this, everybody in the room, everybody in the community, in my opinion, is tired, is anxious, is stressed out, and there's very few answers that are satisfying to give or to get for us broadly with the school system, with us, with our families, with our workplace. So we can keep in mind the amount of progress that can be made in a few weeks till the next meeting. Try to remain optimistic that we can figure all of these things, sports, beat club, and everything else, student council, everything else out. I think we need to hang in there as a community, but I'm sure in 2 weeks when we meet again, there'll be a lot more for any topic of interest for anybody who's attending. So please hang in there. Any other public comment? I had one, seeing none, I had one item I forgot to put in the information. Traditionally, we have had a student rep. Lizzie was a fantastic rep. Blaze, Jackie were the reps. They all were excellent. I would like the board to support my proposal. This is all informal. It's our option. They attend the meetings. They're not on our email strings. They don't have decision making. I think there's a bigger opportunity, particularly in this environment, that student council, Mr. Klingman's class around social and all those, there's other groups that do it, but I talked to Mr. Moynihan. I think having a student council rep be the student voice at every meeting, it gives more of them an opportunity to come, present to the board, get public speaking practice, be able to talk about having done that, so we can involve more students. To me personally, the student rep voice is incredibly important, and I've learned a lot during meetings when they're sharing their updates, so I don't want to take that away, but I want to take it off the shoulders of one of the kids and be able to share that or crowdsource it a little bit. If it ends up being the same kid that comes every time from student council, that's fine, but I think it gives, this could be a more effective forum for some of the student council participation. So, are you supportive of giving that a try?
Oh, definitely. And I think, you know, they're kind of sort of around that's what they able to make, because they're getting whatever going on. So.
Well, I hope that happens many times again this year. But I think that we have a venue, it's a healthy environment.
That's a good idea.
Why don't we have the potential? And if two kids decide they want to run with it, fine. If one kid steps up, but at least it's through that, it could be with the coach on the leader of the student council. It could be, you know, it's still under Mr. Moynihan and Mrs. Reed. So it's just a little bit of a shift, but to me, I think it's broadens a little bit. Good game.
Can I just ask that we're sticking with our policy, Sean, JIBB. Make sure that whoever those students are fitting the eligibility requirements.
Does that work for you, sir?
It does, yep. I'll work with Mr. Holden. I think what I'll try to do, and Mr. Fowler did reach out to me, probably try to come up with some order in which people from student council might pay, a September, an October, November, with possibly a topic, but at the same time, it gives you an opportunity to get a wider range of students and to ask questions. And yeah, I think it'll be, I certainly think it's worth a shot to try for the year. I'll be able to work with Mr. Holden on organizing which student for which month.
And if you want more guidance from us or from me on topics or otherwise, I think we didn't steer or guide the reps in the 3.5 years I've been on the board. We haven't steered them at all. They came in, I learned when everybody else did when they started talking, the board did. So I think there's some leeway for them to still represent the student voice. And, a couple different voices have mentioned something we didn't get into in a lot of discussion tonight, which will be more so in future meetings, is anxiety support, isolation, all those other things. How are our kids feeling? And I think having them have the floor to reasonably share what they're going through is the only way a lot of us are going to get that insight beyond you and your role and Mrs. Reed and Mr. Holden and the other staff. So I appreciate you guys being open to that.
Can I just ask a question?
The student reps in the past, is there like a an avenue for them to take what they learn here, or the information that they glean from a meeting, and bring that back? Like, I don't know who that audience is, but
yeah, they've been really good. So I'll try to answer that moderately quickly. So first of all, we have a principal advisory in school where I meet with different members of each advisory, and I always tell them it's your responsibility to do two things: bring things to me, and also to share things back with the students. Right, so it's a two-way street, so to speak. And so what's been nice is the students who have gone through have met with Mr. Holden. There's usually more than one applicant. And an expectation for them is they're not just coming in and going, here's the issues, and then, hey, thanks for having a discussion. They've done a very good job of reaching out to the students and soliciting feedback. So they often come from a leadership role in some way from the school anyway. Some of them have been Hobie youth leaders. Some of them have been on the student council or presidents of their class. So they have a lot of experience with that. If they didn't do that, we'd probably be more apt to, hey, make sure that these conversations that happen on the school board get back to them. But you've seen how they are at the school board. They're pretty prepared in a lot of ways, and they've been able to share that information back. And so that's what they're able to do. They really do reach back out to their classmates in a number of ways.
Thanks for that. So thanks all for being here. It's not a big change, but I think it would be helpful. You guys are great, great student reps, but if we could broaden that out, that'd be good. Any additional agenda items? We had the Article 8 committee, discussion by the board, deadline request consideration, committee's format, EEI presentation, having them come and give an overview, project examples, wanted to wait until next meeting to have that, so I want to have that on there. They're consultants we've hired to help us figure out potential solutions to keep the elementary school safe. Athletics update, but I would have done that anyway. And then something around what are the support mechanisms for the unrest and anxiety, if you could speak through to what the students are coming back to. Is it what we've had all along? I'm putting it on the spot a little bit here with a not complete thought. Okay. But if I just moved here and I didn't know guidance, I didn't know the principles, what's some insight into how we're helping in an unprecedented time with overwhelming anxiety, those things? Just what's in place for that?
Yep.
I think it would be helpful for the community to hear. Do you guys have other topics you want to add? All right. We need to close this meeting and go into non-public. So let's get a motion to close this meeting, and then I'll make a motion. We need a second. Yes, it's non-public. That work? We'll leave from there. So this meeting's going to be done. Motion from Scott Risman to close the meeting at 7:19.
Second.
Seconded by Ed. Thank you, everybody, for coming. Really appreciate it. Please pop your masks on until you're out of the building. See you in 2 weeks. Keep checking SAU85.org for updates. Yeah. Yep.